Good evening, everyone. So, picking up from where we left off in the last video, just to recap, we had configured the devices in the production and the access zones, also the access and the switch, which is acting as a production and access switch, and we configured the SVIs for the production and the access VLANs on the core. And we confirm connectivity from the core to the access and production devices. So to start off, just a bit of housework really. I'd noticed that I hadn't named some things correctly and I missed some descriptions in the last video. So we'll go back and tidy them up. So as per our design document, this access core switch here sits in zone 5, so it should be core switch 501. This switch here that sits in the DC zone should be core switch 101. For some reason I called them DC switch and access core. CSW 501. CSW 101. The naming scheme there, CSW stands for core switch, 1 is the zone, and 01 is the first switch, first core switch in that zone. This as well, this will be, that's an access switch in zone 2 for the DMZ, and that's the first one. That's also an access switch in zone 2, and that's the second switch. Okay, we'll start the core back up. We'll start the DC switch back up. So the main aims of this lab, once we've gone back and named a few interfaces on the access switches, this video is going to be about getting the core up and running. So these interfaces that connect to pretty much everything else. We're also going to configure these two interfaces on the DC core switch. Just so that we can test our configuration on the core switch. So we will have a OSPF link running between these two, which will hopefully come up. So first off then, access switch 512. Maybe if we split this so we can see both. There we go. Okay, so again, the host name on this, we didn't call it the right thing, so give it its proper name, access switch 512. And again, ASW access switch, 5 for zone 5, and this is switch 12. So the way I usually do it is I will leave switches 1 to 5 for a main comms room, switches 6 to 10 for a secondary comms room, and start the access switches at 11 and onwards. Okay, so we have gig 00 with no description. So this is going to core switch 501 port gig 1/2. 01 has no description either, and that's going to 1/3. And the port channel doesn't have a description either. Yep, call switch 501, port channel 12. There we go, much better. Hop on to switch 511. We'll change the host name. Gig 00. We'll just confirm that it hasn't got a description. Yep, it doesn't. This is going to call switch 501 interface gig 2/0. And gig 01 is going to 2/1. And interface port channel 11 going to call switch 501 PO 11. There we go, much better. Okay, we'll change the host name. It's quite a handy little trick there if people aren't aware of this. If you're in global config, you can use the do command to execute shell commands. Okay, so 00 we're not configured yet, nor 01. 10 or 11, but 1/2, 1/3, 2/0 and 2/01 we have. So let's give them some descriptions. So start from the top, 1/2. Going to access switch 512, port gig 0/0. 1/3 is going to gig 0/1. 2/0 going to access switch 511 gig 0/0. And 2/1 is going to gig 0/1. Let's not forget the port channels. Okay, so we know what's what now. Okay, so now we can start figuring the rest of the switch. So let's focus on the links between the call switch and the FTDs. So if we look at our network diagram, we said that the transit networks were going to start at 301. And that would be the first network in the 10.11.0.0/24, but broken down into /29s. So this is the one we're interested in here. And we're also carrying the production VLAN for VLAN 65 up through the call switch. So this needs to be a trunk interface carrying VLAN 301 and 65. We also need to have interface VLAN 301 configured on the switch. And that's going to be what we use to route to the rest of the access networks off of the call. Yep, so we'll create our VLANs first. Transit one. We'll create the transit network for the core switch to the DC switch as well while we're here. 302 name transit 2, and we'll create the SVIs while we're here. So as we said, VLAN 301 will be the first subnet in the 10.11.0.0 network, split up into /29s, which is a 248 subnet mask, and we'll no shut it. We'll do the same for VLAN 302. So this will effectively be 8 IP numbers up. Confirm our configuration. Ah, okay. I configured the name for VLAN 301 twice instead of configuring VLAN 302. This is why it always pays to check your work. Okay, that looks better. And if we do show IP interface brief, we should be able to see our SVIs that we've just created as well. So 301, 302. Okay, seems to have misconfigured interface VLAN 301 as well. Might give it its network address. Okay. .11.0.1. So we'll give all the lowest IPs in the network ranges to the core switch. Okay, there we go. Just while I'm thinking about it, notice this a few times. This is getting in my way a bit. We're going to linecon 0. We'll run this command called login synchronous. And what this will do for us is when we have any status messages pop up, if we're typing, it actually drops us onto a new line and gives us the rest of the command that we've already typed rather than splitting it into two. Just makes it a bit easier to work with. Okay, so let's go ahead and now configure the ports. Now we have the VLANs and the SVIs ready. So first up is interface gig 00. We'll give this a description first off. And this is going to be the FTD1 link to gig 0/1. We know it's going to be a trunk. We'll tell it to have the encapsulation .1q. We'll tell it to be a trunk. And we'll tell it what VLANs are allowed. For this, which will be 65, we said that's the production network that's going to terminate on the firewalls. So the core is just acting as a layer 2 hop for this. And then 301, which will be our transit network to route out. We will tell it not to negotiate to be an access port, only a trunk as we told it to be. And we will stick it in a ether channel. We'll stick it in group 1, and we're going to statically configure the ether channel this time. Okay, and we'll configure the other port in the CIFA channel, which is 0/2. Description for this, this one's going off to FTD 2 at the same interface, gig 0/1, but on a different firewall. And we'll run the same lot of commands again, so switch port trunk encapsulation dot 1q, switch port mode trunk, switch port trunk allowed VLANs 65 and 301. Switch port no negotiate, channel group 1 mode on. And then we'll drop into port channel 1 configuration. And we will rob that last lot of commands that we just used. Paste them into that and we'll give it a description. So this will be FTD PO1. We'll just call it PO2 FTD. Oh, okay, and I've configured the wrong interface there. Missed an interface out. Okay, so that's not a problem. We go into interface gig 0/1. We copy this. And then we drop into global config and we say defaults interface gig 0/2. Character out of the description, gig 0/1. I did it again. Okay. Description for this one, FTD 1, gig 0/1. Description for that one, FTD 2, 0/1. Okay, let's try that again. Okay, much better. So the two interfaces, both in the trunk and PO1, off to the FTDs. Okay, so let's do the two interfaces to the DC switch, which are 101 and 101. Description for switch 101 gig 1/0. So this is going to be an access port. This is only going to be the transit VLAN 302 going across this. So switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 302. Again, switch port no negotiate. And we're going to have a ether channel here as well. Channel group 2. And again, we're going to configure this statically. Jump over to interface 1/1 and give it its description. Let's go into core switch 101, interface gig 1/1. We will tell it to be an access port. We'll tell it to be in VLAN 302. We'll tell it only to be an access port, and we'll tell it to go ahead and put itself into channel group 2. And we'll drop into the configuration for port channel 2. And we will steal them last few lines of configuration that we just had there. Okay, so what was this? CDP message, native VLAN mismatch between 1/0, Ethernet 1/0. Oh no, gigabit Ethernet, sorry. And 0/0. Okay, so that must be. That's got to be that link there. Yep, and that will change when we configure the other end of the port channel. So let's double check our work. So it's ports 1, 0, and 1, 1. Going off to call switch 101. Access ports in VLAN 302. Yep, that's fine. That should change when we go and configure switch 101. And we'll have a quick check of the Ether channels as well. Obviously these two won't be up yet because the other side isn't up, but we have the right ports in them. Okay, strangely enough, it thinks that channel group 1 should be up. Not exactly sure why. Okay, so we will turn on IP routing and we will configure our OSPF configuration. So nothing too complicated, just turn on OSPF, tell it to be on for pretty much all of our 10.11.0 networks to cover all our transit links. And we'll stick that in area 0. We'll save that. We'll jump on to the DC switch. Okay, we'll give it its host name. We will configure VLAN 302. There's transit. We'll also configure the VLAN and the SVI for the server VLAN, just so that we have something to advertise into OSPF, so we can actually check on the call switch that we're receiving them routes. So in the DC, the service subnet is 10.11.17. So VLAN 17. Name, DC servers. We'll go ahead and we'll configure the SVIs for these networks. V.10. .9 was the call switch. We'll unshut that. And we'll go back into a line con 0. And we'll do login synchronous on here as well. Okay, we'll configure the SVI for VLAN 17, which was 10.11.17.1 /24, and we'll no shut that. Okay. VLAN 17, VLAN 302. Interface VLAN 17, interface VLAN 302. Okay. So, time for the interfaces. So, interface 00. Oh, I thought that was going to be 10. What did I put on the description for 10 on this course? 10 going to 10. Yeah, that's incorrect. Gig 0/0. We will add VLAN 301 and 302 to that. Okay, so interface gig 0/0, description, call switch 501, gig 1/0, and this is a access port. It's going to be in VLAN 302. We want it only ever to be an access port, and we want to stick it into channel group 2. And it was static on the other end, so we'll make it static on this end. We will now configure 1/1. That goes off to call switch 501 on gig 1/1. Also going to be an access port. Also going to be in 302. Only ever want it to be an access port, and it's also going to be in channel group 2. Okay, I'll jump in to channel groups 2 interface. Give it a description, PO2 call switch 501. We really should have put them two interfaces together, really, but never mind. Okay. Yep, we'll go on and we'll turn on IP routing on here as well. We'll configure OSPF. Also an area 0. We will now need to bounce these ports. And 1/0 through 1/1. Shut and no shut them, that'll bring them out of the error disabled states, and we should hopefully panel misconfig. Okay, we have 1/0. Access port VLAN 302. Zero. Access port VLAN 302. Both statically configured in the port group. Port group number doesn't matter. are disabled. Okay, so let's change these ports. /0/1 and switch channel group 2, and we'll change it to LACP, see if this makes a difference. This was gig 0/0 gig/1. Channel group 2 mode active. Oh, okay. So we have to do no channel group 2 mode on. Funnily enough, we didn't get that error. Oh, yes, we did. Okay. So no channel group 2 mode on. Bounce these ones and unshut them. That is interesting. Looks fine to me. LACP not enabled on remote port. 0/0 1/1 PO2 0/0/1/1, that's definitely the right ports. Or LACP. Access port in VLAN 302. 1/0/1/1. Port in VLAN 302. Using LACP. There, 1/0/1/1. Okay, I'm going to pause the video there. I'm going to take a look at this and then come back and tell you what the solution was. Okay, that didn't take too long. I think the mistake I made was I just bounced the individual ports. The issue appears to be that the switches don't like the statically configured port channels between them. And when I changed it to LACP, I only bounced the physical ports and not the port channel. As soon as I bounced the port channel, it came back up. And we can see there we've achieved our OSPF neighborship. So what we want to see now, if we do show IP routes. We want to see the 10.11.17 network on the access call with a bit of luck. Okay, that's not down. I think that's because the SVI itself isn't up because there's nothing in that interface. Yeah, there we go. So if we just we'll spin up with Windows Server. 1/0 Okay, and just get it connected for now. Okay, so might look a bit funny this, but we're having three network adapters. The third network adapter I know for a fact is just created when you enable RDP through EVNG. So it's a matter of figuring out which interface is which. So interface gig or 1/0. Shut that. The other NIC card here is connected to the management network, and eventually we will go and put that on the 10.11.16 network. And I have a leg into that network on my computer just so I can remote directly onto these boxes using RDP. Okay, none of them interfaces have gone down. That's 1/0. Okay, well let's try it the other way then. Yeah, that's definitely the RDP one because that's just killed my connection. So let's stop and start that. Okay, this must be an anomaly within EVNG then. It's not something I've come across before this. Do it the old-fashioned way. Okay, so we are looking for ends in 02. That's not us. That ends in all zeros. 5000000E. Yeah, I think that's us. So just Ethernet adapter. Excuse me. Ah, it's because that one's disabled. Okay, well, it must be this one then. So we'll give it an IP in the range we want. 10.11.17.11, 24-bit mask. Gateway.1, let's use Google for that. And that would bring up interface vlan 17. Yeah, and that means that now we should see it in the routing table of the access call. Ah, of course. The network statement isn't wide enough. So we're going to router OSPF 1. We originally had 10.11.0.0. We have a 24-bit mask which only includes 10.11.0. We want a slash 16. And we want it in area 0. We want to do the same for the access call. Should have run pipe section router. Okay, so we can do a no network 10.11.0.0, as that is now defunct. Okay, and there we go. There's our first routes learned via OSPF from the data center network. Okay, so that's as far as we'll take it today, and we'll carry on probably with the DMZ and the firepowers next. Okay, well, I hope you have enjoyed the video. If you have, please like, share, subscribe, and thank you for watching.